Today we are discussing about meshes of central tendency. What is mesh of central tendency? Among a set of data, when we want to find out what is the central value, we use meshes of central tendency. And broadly speaking, meshes of central tendency are often called averages. Commonly used methods to find measures of central tendency are mean, median, and mode. Traditionally, we are using mean for a long time. Mean is otherwise called arithmetic mean. And it is observed, or mean will represent, or mean will give what is the central value for a set of data. For finding out mean, all observations are summed, or we'll add all observations and then it will be divided by total number of observations. If x1, x2, x3, etc. up to xn are n number of observations, arithmetic mean or x bar is calculated by adding the variables. Then it is divided with total number of observations. In this case, sigma x represents the sum of variables and x bar represents mean. This x1, x2, x3 are different observations and n is the total number of observations. See this examples. We are having 10 variables out here. This number 10 represent n and these are the number of observations. For finding out this mean, we added the 10 values, then it is divided by 10, and then we will get the result. This is the case of a simple data set. We are also having frequency distribution and also grouped frequency distributions. Let's move on to frequency distribution. When the number of variables are too high, often we represent the data in the form of tables. One kind of such distribution is called a frequency distribution, where the repeating values are represented with their corresponding frequencies. This is a typical table showing frequency distribution. When we are dealing with frequency distribution, the formula mean sigma x by n is slightly changed. Here we will go to sigma fx by n, where f is the frequency, x is the corresponding variable, and n is the total number of observations. But there is a variation. In the place of x, we are summing x and a corresponding frequency. And also, in the case of n, for finding out n, we are adding all the frequencies together. So in this problem, each variables are multiplied with their corresponding frequency to get xf, and n is calculated by adding all frequencies and applying to this formula, we will come to this conclusion. And so first we discussed about simple data distribution, or simple data distribution. There we used sigma x by n. Second is frequency distribution. Here we used sigma fx by n. And there is also another kind of distribution that is called grouped frequency distribution. And in the case of grouped frequency distribution, the fx, sigma fx by n formula is modified to sigma fm by n, where m is the midpoint of each class. Let's go to a grouped frequency table. See, this is the grouped frequency table 5155, and corresponding frequency is 2. And these each individual groups are called classes. So here there are 4 classes. And in the case of first class, 51 is the lower boundary and 55 is the upper boundary. And their frequency, corresponding frequency is 2. The first step to do this kind of mean calculation is to find out the midpoint. Midpoint is calculated by summing the lower class boundary and upper class boundary divided by 2. For each class, we have to do this calculation. So we will arrive at the midpoints. Midpoints are considered as x. Now applying the formula, each midpoints or midpoints corresponding to each class is multiplied with their corresponding frequency, and that is called MF or sigma or FM. These values are added together to get sigma FX, and they are divided by N. Here also, N is calculated by adding the frequencies together. So, the intention or the message for this class, or what we want to do in this class, is there are different kinds of measures of central tendency are present. They include mean, median and mode. The most simple and the first group of measures of central tendency is mean. Mean is calculated by adding the values and then dividing it by total number of values. In the case of a simple distribution, the formula used is sigma x by n. But in the case of frequency distribution, the formula used will be sigma fx by n, where each values are multiplied with their corresponding frequencies. And also, n is found out with, or n is calculated by adding total frequencies. But in the case of grouped frequency distribution, the formula is adapted to or changed to sigma fm by n, where m is the midpoint of each class. Thank you, and we will continue with the remaining portion on the next class.